I think related to that is also in terms of creating an environment for the team. It's one of accountability, one of collaboration. So tracking, you know, tracking progress, tracking deliverables, and also encouraging the team to work across the different organizational silos. Yeah, even startups have them, although in a much smaller scale. I think that seems super important.
Let's talk about product, right? I believe you know you guys have a couple of products. So maybe you can tell us more about what products you have.
Yeah, so we have, I would say, three main product areas. First one would be customer-facing app, which we allow customers to book and create an account and manage their appointments with. The second one would be for our healthcare professionals, where they can receive, they can sign up for different appointments or different visits. And last but not least, on the back end, we have administration tools in order to manage all the different care that's going on, right? And to be able to just have an overview of the two sides of the ecosystem. So our mobile apps are mainly focused on our healthcare professionals, because we recognize that we made a call early on that they needed the tight integration of fully native applications. So we built a healthcare professional application called the Jaga-Me-me app on React Native, and deploy it on both the Google and App Store as well as the Apple one. And for the customers, however, we did it through a mobile web. So we made a call to essentially make it available cross-platform, unlike many other client partners. I mean, companies who really focus a lot on the native apps. We decided that it would be one of the potential ways to make it easier for people to arrange care using a desktop or an app, a mobile phone, if they so wanted it. So we made a decision early on, but that's some of the background behind the product decisions lah.
So you mentioned the main reason of going towards web, right, is basically for ease of use, right? And do you guys do any research, or you know, do you guys talk to any potential users or understand the market to make this decision?
Yeah, I think at that point of time we had looked into some studies where I think the number that we saw cited was that about 70% of users would not download an app just to use a service, right? Especially the first time users. Perhaps it's also dated at that point of time, but we do monitor some of the usage data. We see a lot of people using desktops during their office hours, because I suppose maybe they're working in the office and they just need to make sure some arrangements are made for the other loved ones, and the web browser does serve as one way to do so, right? But there are definitely a lot of pluses that you can harness from the a fully native mobile app as well. And I think it's not that we necessarily made a permanently right choice, but these are some of the considerations we made, the usage patterns, the user behavior. And we do see a lot of working professionals using Jaga-Me on the client side. So we definitely have that experience from allowing them to arrange their can access our platform using the desktop as well.
Nice. It's really great to see how you use technology to really kind of, you know, make this whole process seamless, right? On checking, you know, how my uncle or auntie or my parent is doing, you know, if whether the nurse has reached that the destination and all that, right? So can you share what is the hardest thing, right, about shipping a product out to the market?
I think there are a lot of hard things in order to ship a product to market. I think the hardest thing is to create a team that can, you know, do it independent of you, in a sense, as a founder. I think building a team with the right varied skill set and, you know, and to inculcate in them the sense of urgency, the quality, quality concentration, and also empathy for the customer. I think that one is the hardest part. Once we've created a team, I believe that that's one flywheel that, you know, you've already created, and they can continue to do build more products, right? I think related to that is also in terms of creating an environment for the team. It's one of accountability, one of collaboration. Tracking progress, tracking deliverables, and also encouraging the team to work across the different organizational silos. Yeah, even startups have them, although in a much smaller scale. I think that's super important, and that will enable the company to self-sustain and build that momentum around product shipping.
Nice. It's really interesting that you really talk about the people who are building the product rather than the product itself, right? And speaking about silos, and it even happened in startups, right? In smaller companies, how do you break that silos in, you know, different departments? Or are there any like tips that you would like to share with us?
I think the founders or top management have a huge role to play in order to break down the silos. On one hand, you know, we need to have regular cross department, you know, intra department or intra company sessions for bonding and also for brainstorming. I think that's really important. We particularly implemented a company-wide sprint system whereby we can conduct product rollouts that require different teams. We can conduct it in a regular and measured cadence, and be able to basically carve out time and resources as required for people, different members to come on board. And I think it's one of the ways that we currently manage the entire process internally.
Nice. So like bringing people together for a common goal, you know, kind of helps to break the silos as well, right? So everybody kind of sees everybody contributing together, right? Running towards the same direction.
And a big part also is in terms of hiring. You need to hire people with a very team-based mindset. Sometimes you have strong individual contributors that you hire, but they have very low, you know, team collaboration score, so to speak. And I think it's really important to find both, that they have a strong individual contributor skill set, at the same time are able to synergize with other people, and especially as when you need to find needs of the internal customers and external customers. It's super important.